Hey guys, I have another video for you. I want to talk about the difference between burning calories in general and burning fat calories. Isn't the goal to burn fat calories? So many people say, well, I'm going to go out and exercise. I have to burn up my calories. I just ate, you know, they're in the calorie burning. But what kind of calories are they burning typically? When you actually go out and exercise, it's very rare that you're going to burn any fat calories at all. In fact, go ahead and try this experiment. Go ahead and work out 3 hours, weigh yourself just before the workout and right after and see how much weight that you lost. It'll be zero because the calories that you burn when you exercise are mainly sugar, stored sugar calories in the form of glycogen. Glycogen is a bunch of sugar molecules attached together, glucose molecules attached together as one unit, and that's called glycogen. So you store it in the muscle and you store it in the liver, okay? So when you exercise, you basically tap out your glycogen reserve. So you deplete it, and then you think, oh wow, I burned up my calories, I'm gonna lose weight, right? Well, it depends. What really determines if you to burn fat calories is if you keep your dietary carbohydrates or glucose really low. The big mistake that I see when people work out is they'll eat some fruit after the workout, they'll drink a protein sugar shake, they'll drink some juice after the workout, Gatorade with the glucose and fructose, you know, as their electrolyte, and it pretty much nullified any benefit of exercise because as soon as that sugar goes in there, that exercise, you're gonna basically burn up that sugar instead of your own fat, okay? If you exercise in the absence of glucose or sugar, diet-wise, you will trigger hormones that will then work for you 24 to 48 hours later, okay, when you're sleeping. So that's really the benefit of exercise. It's in the recovery later, not during the workout. But if you have any sugar before, during, or after, you pretty much are not going to be burning this type of calorie right here. And I think people give this give the wrong importance to calories as a whole. They think, well, eat everything in moderation. Eat less and you'll lose weight because, of course, you know, calories in, calories out. Well, no, that's not how it works. And if you avoid fat calories, they have the most dense calories or more calories per unit than carbs or protein. But the fat calories are neutral when it comes down to triggering insulin. So when you're eating less calories, it really talks about what type of calories are you eating less of? If you're eating less of carbohydrate calories, then you're good. If you're eating less of fat calories and keeping your carbohydrates high, it's very, very bad. You're not going to lose fat. So it's not about burning calories, it's about burning fat calories. To do that, you have to keep your glucose and your sugar as low as possible. I like to recommend keep it below between 20 and 50 grams. If you really want to lose weight, keep it below 20, okay? And that's what's going to help. It's not about eating less calories. It's not about exercising. It's about understanding the whole picture hormonally. Thanks for watching. Hey, you probably already subscribed, but if you haven't, press this little button down below, and I will keep you updated.